And so who's coming over? Because I have a pot full, okay? Who's coming over? What's up, and welcome back to my channel, your girl Miriam. And today, baby, we have ourselves some Louisiana style jambalaya. Already squealing, okay? I'm gonna already stop talking and just dig in. I'm so hungry. It's almost 2 o'clock. All right, here we go. Sausage. I want a piece of everything. It's gonna be a really big bite. Come on, baby. And can you focus on me? Baby, can you focus? I ain't stopped talking yet. Yes, ma'am. Guys, it is so good. Give me 1 minute. Now, I did taste a little bit. When it was boiling, for salt. But it's perfect. It is absolutely delicious. Oh my gosh. It has, the heat is probably about medium. You know me, I don't really like anything super spicy. And those meats are still juicy. It is so good. I I don't like the heat to overpower the flavor of the food. I just wanted to compliment it. It's probably, the heat is very tolerable, but it's probably a tad bit spicier than I would probably prefer, but I'm still gonna eat it. Okay. It's so good. I decided to make this because it was one day, it's probably been a week now, I was hungry, and I was like, I need something to eat. And I literally whipped up some jambalaya in like, I kid you not, in like 30 minutes. But I only made like a portion. It was probably a little bit bigger than this. Maybe like enough where it was two times this. And that was it versus that big, huge pot. It was probably about this much times two. But I made it with salmon and shrimp. I was shocked myself. 30 minutes. Made it up. Had all the ingredients here to make it. And even for this, I had all the ingredients except for the sausage. The sausage and the green pepper. It's the only thing I had to go to the store for. Mmm. Very good. Those 2 cups of rice, I would suggest to make just 3 cups of water and then kind of taper in about a half a cup because you don't want to be overly mushy because it's already going to be a lot of liquid in the rice. You've already rinsed it, so there's the water there. There's a lot of water in the meat. There's a lot of water in those veggies. So, because one thing about with rice, you can always add water, but you can't take any away. So, after you wash your rice and everything, I pour in just 3 cups of water with 2 cups of rice and then kind of go from there. But you probably won't need any more than a half a cup. You definitely won't need 4 cups. It is not, jambalaya is not a 2-to-1 ratio as far as the rice and water. And my meat is not dry. Add your meat in early if you want to while it's boiling, but I just feel like I don't like tough meat, you know, but I like my meat juicy and tender. So that's why I added it in about 10 minutes before it's done. It's about 70% cooked. So you cook all your meats about 50%. After you pull all your meat out, it's still going to be cooking. So it'll be about 70% done by the time it kind of cools down a little bit. Then you're adding it to the pot where you're cooking your rice another 10 minutes. So with all that steam and the rice and everything like that, it's going to cook down some more. So I just don't want it to be overcooked because chicken and shrimp can tend to get really tough. Mmm. So good. Didn't go by any directions or anything. It kind of went off the top of my head. And that's just the truth. Mmm. So good. Mmm. So how are you guys doing today? How are you doing? Silly, I know. How are you doing? I'm doing just fine. Mmm. Don't have to use Andouille sausage. Use turkey if you like. If you're vegan, of course, you can replace your meats with tofu. Maybe chickpeas would be nice. Mmm, it's so good. And so who's coming over? Because I have a pot full, okay? Who is coming over? Mmm. Again, I want to reiterate something. Please, 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 please be highly aware of scams, okay? There are scammers out there. When I notice it, I'll just block them and report them. And that's only the best thing I can do. But just please be mindful. All the time, I get emails all the time from different companies suggesting that I order, suggesting that I do a sponsorship with them. But just be aware, okay? It's all over social media. It's in your personal emails. Not just on my platform, but just be aware. I would never DM you. I would never email you first. I would respond, even though sometimes I don't respond to DMs because it's in a different section. But I would never do anything first. And anytime I have a prize or a giveaway, a sponsorship, you will know it in the content that I'm giving to you just like here and now. It would never be a surprise in the comment section. And plus you can also see that the check mark that I'm the one who's verified. These people who make up a completely different YouTube channel or other social media account in my name, YouTube is where the only place is where I'm actually verified. But so just personally, socially, just be aware of scams. I just felt like I had to say that because some people just don't know. Some people just think like, you know me. I've been watching my channel for a while and it seemed like something that I would do, but I would never do it without announcing it first. Okay, so please always know that. I feel like I need to, I feel like I need to say that every once in a while on my channel. So personally, socially, always be aware of scammers, okay? So I love you guys. I'm gonna cut it here. So if you are new to the channel, baby, welcome. Welcome. Thank you so much for subscribing. Thank you so much for being a part of the fam. As always, I greatly appreciate all of you. God bless you. And I'll see you on my next video. Peace.